My name is Vincent Liu, Product Manager here at Microsoft Azure Files and File Sync team. Today, I'm very excited to introduce our new provision version 2 model for HDD File Share.
Currently, we offer pay-as-you-go model for HDD File Shares and provision version 1 model for SSD File Shares. The new provision version 2 will focus on HDD File Shares. To understand it better, let's quickly recap on the pay-as-you-go and provision version 1 models. Following the three specific access tiers that we currently offer, the pay-as-you-go model allows you to only pay for the capacity you use. However, one of the feedback items we received is it is very hard to predict the cost of ownership of these file shares upfront. An alternative to the pay-as-you-go model is the provision billing model, which lets you set capacity and scale IOPS and throughput linearly. This helps control the total cost of ownership on the file shares upfront. To improve the provisioning model and offer both flexibility and cost predictability, we're introducing the provision version 2 billing model. This model lets you independently scale capacity, IOPS, and throughput to meet your evolving workload needs. With provision version 2, you can also monitor individual file shares, which can range from 32 GB to 256 TB in size, with up to 50,000 IOPS and 5 GB per second throughputs, providing flexibility for both small and large workloads.
For special circumstances requiring extra IOP usage, the Burst IOP feature offers up to 3 times the preset IOP limits. Burst credit accumulate when the file share returned to regular usage at a 1-to-1 ratio of each unused IOP per second against the baseline provision IOPS. For those who intended to have file sync service linked to HDD file share, provision version 2 is a great choice. Compared to the pay-as-you-go model, you can eliminate the expense of daily sync transactions, which are usually a significant part of the monthly bill. Now, let's take a closer look at the step-by-step process of setting up a provision version 2 file share. First, navigate to the Azure portal page. Here, I will go to the resource group that I created for this demo in advance. Next, type storage account in the search bar and click create. Enter the intended storage account name and choose a region that currently supports provision version 2 pricing model. For more information on available regions, please refer to the documentation. Select Azure Files as your primary service and choose Standard for the performance. For file share billing, choose Provision V2, and then select the desired redundancy based on your needs. Proceed to the Review plus Create section. Once validation is complete, click Create. After the deployment is ready, go to the resource. On the overview page, you will see that the file share billing is provision V2, indicating that we have successfully created a storage account with the provision version 2 pricing model. Next, look at the side panel under data storage and select file shares. Click add file share. Enter the desired name and choose the size for the file share. Under performance, you have the flexibility to either choose our recommendation or manually input both variables. If you change your mind, you can always adjust these settings after the file share is created. Once everything is set up, proceed to create the file share. Now you have a provision version 2 file share ready to go. Now let's look at where to find metrics in the portal and the billing details for provision version 2 file shares. You can view settings like provision IOPS, capacity, and throughput in the overview section. To change settings, click Change Size and Performance at the top. Note that you can only decrease these settings every 24 hours. To monitor IOPS per file share, click Monitoring in the sidebar, then Metrics, and choose the correct file share for data visualization. File share provision IOPS shows the current provision IOPS, while transactions indicate actual IOPS usage. To check burst IOP capability, choose burst credit for IOPS under transaction. hover over each metric to learn more. Provision version 2 file shares will be built based on provision storage, IOPS, throughput, overflow snapshot usage, and soft delete usage. Overflow snapshot refers to any amount of differential snapshot usage in gigabyte that does not fit within the provision storage capacity, while soft delete refers to storage capacity usage for soft deleted file shares. Compared to the provision version 1 pricing model, which is built hourly at a monthly rate, the provision version 2 file service is built hourly at an hourly rate. Now, let's see how we can use the collected data to drive a lower total cost of ownership for business. First, regularly check the metrics, as they provide insights about usage. Specifically, target the transaction and burst aisle features. While some people use the burst aisle feature as much as possible, we recommend treating burst IOP as a backup option. Ideally, provision at a capacity level that can handle business peak usage. Secondly, test a file share to see its performance and capabilities help decide how to distribute workloads to meet specific needs. When pressure test, remember to scale out. If tests are run on one file, it will always be in one node in the data center, limiting to a certain maximum capacity. Instead, spread out the testing by test multiple files to see the real working scenario's performance.
Thirdly, keep adjusting capacity, IOPS, and throughput on the file share as your application grows to avoid hitting provision limits and getting throttled. Burst credits can help alleviate IOPS peaks, but make sure to increase provision IOPS and throughput for the best workload experience.
To get started with Azure Files and Provision Version 2 pricing model, please refer to our documentation. Thank you for your time.